Hi friends, today we will talk about lithium. Lithium is an anti-manic drug, that is, it is used mainly in mania and bipolar disorder. Lithium is a small monovalent cation and is handled by the kidneys in the same way as sodium. So how does it act? Lithium mainly inhibits the breakdown of inositol monophosphate to inositol. This results in a decrease in free inositol and subsequently a decrease of PIP2. PIP2, as we know, is a precursor of second messengers IP3 and DAG in the cell membrane. These two second messengers are responsible for various effects. Now, PIP2 dependent pathways are thought to be increased in mania. So, treatment with lithium is expected to decrease the activity in these pathways and provide relief in mania. Let us now move on to the pharmacokinetics of lithium, which is quite interesting. Always remember that lithium has a narrow margin of safety. That is, there is a very narrow window between the effective doses and the doses at which it produces adverse effects. So, it is a very appropriate drug for therapeutic drug monitoring. An important point we should always remember is that the therapeutic range of lithium is 0.6 to 1.2 milliequivalent per liter. And the toxicity appears if the plasma concentration increases to more than 1.5 milliequivalent per liter. Now, within the range 0.6 to 1.2, the concentration range 1 to 1.2 is preferred for acute mania, whereas the concentration range 0.6 to 0.8 is considered suitable and safe for long-term maintenance therapy. It is also worth noting that lithium is filtered at the glomerulus. Around 80% is reabsorbed in the proximal tubules, and lithium competes with sodium for reabsorption. The absorption of lithium is increased in conditions of sodium loss, such as diuretic use, diarrhea, dehydration, etc. Hence, dehydration should be particularly avoided and patients should be encouraged to drink plenty of fluids. Now, let us discuss the various adverse effects. The mnemonic by which we can remember the adverse effects is the word lithium itself. So, let us see how it works. The letters L and I refers to leukocytes increased. Increased leukocytes somewhere around 12 to 15,000 almost always occurs during therapy. This is benign and reverses to normal after the therapy is stopped. T refers to tremors. Tremors is the most common adverse effect of lithium. It occurs at therapeutic doses and is treated by propranolol or atenolol. Other CNS adverse effects can include athetosis, dysarthria, aphasia, etc. H refers to hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism is reversible and non-progressive, and it manifests as benign, diffuse, non-tender thyroid enlargement. Next comes the letter I and U. I and U refers to increased urination, that is polyuria and polydipsia. It occurs due to inhibition of ADH action and it may respond to amiloride and is reversible on stopping lithium therapy. The last letter M refers to expectant or pregnant mothers. That is, lithium is contraindicated during pregnancy because if given during pregnancy, lithium may cause fetal goiter or Epstein's anomaly. Epstein's anomaly is a unique anomaly characterized by tricuspid atresia in the newborn. We now move on to the uses of lithium. Lithium is mainly used in two conditions. One, profile excess of bipolar disorder, and two, treatment of acute mania. The first one, that is profile excess of bipolar disorder, is the most common and definite indication of lithium. Lithium prevents episodes of both mania as well as depression in bipolar disorder. However, most cases relapse when lithium is discontinued. The second indication is treatment of acute mania. Now here, lithium has a slow onset of action. That is, it takes 7 to 14 days for the effects to manifest. Hence, it is always given along with an atypical antipsychotic such as aripiprazole, vipracidone, etc. or a benzodiazepine. The atypical antipsychotic or the benzodiazepine provides cover for the initial 7 to 14 day period until the effects of lithium becomes manifest. Thanks for watching. If you find the information in this video beneficial, please like, share and subscribe this video. Thank you.